lovely people, my name's Nicole, and a few weeks ago I made a video of my literary turn-offs, the things that I see in books and make me run the other way. So today I thought I would make the sort of inverse of that video and talk about my literary turn-ons, I guess, would be the reverse of that. The things that if I hear they are in books, that means I am running to the bookstore, I need to pick up this book as soon as possible. Basically, these things that if I hear they're in a book, I may just pick up that book purely based on that one thing. Some people call them bookish buzzwords, whatever you want to call them. These are some of my favorite things to read in books. So the first one is fairy tale retellings. I love fairy tale retellings. I will read almost any fairy tale retelling. They make me happy because they're classic stories that I already know and love, but cooler because they involve more badass magic, or contemporary romance, or awesome fairies, or cyborgs. Just amazing things like that. Fairy tale retellings are just the cupcakes of the book world. The second thing I love to read about are assassins, especially badass female assassins. Like, male assassins are cool, but like, give me a really badass, take no shit female assassin and I'm yours forever and ever and ever. I just like to see cool girls kicking ass. Number three is queer and especially bisexual characters, especially queer and bi women. Part of that is just because I'm a bisexual queer woman, and so I like to read books that I can identify with. There have been multiple books that I have been very hesitant to pick up, like, I don't really know if they're my thing, and then somebody tells me, oh, well, there's a queer character in it, and I'm like, okay, reading it. I just really like supporting authors that are giving great representation to the community. I also think it's really important for these books to be available, especially to teenagers and people who are currently trying to figure out their identity and who they are and who they want to be, because it can be an educational tool to teach them about different kinds of people and different kinds of identities that are in the world and allow them to learn about all their options and all the diversity that's in the world. All right, so the fourth thing that I love to read in books is hate to love or hate to friendship to love relationships. I think it's just so cute when characters go from this not necessarily like good and evil kind of hate, but just sort of like rivalry. Like, they're on the same side, but they're also kind of at ends with each other kind of hate, and then eventually they just grow close because they're kind of just forged together, and then they fall in love with each other. And if they build a really solid friendship and then realize, oh shit, I have more than friendship feelings, that is even better. But I just feel like these relationships are always so fantastic and adorable because you know how hard they had to work to get there. And then also, I find that these relationships always are the most bantery and funny, and they're just adorable and I love them. And my final bookish buzz concept thing is books about books and books about people who love books. I just find that books about people who love books always just feel really comforting to me. I don't necessarily know 100% why that is. Maybe just because I'm someone who really loves books, but reading about people who love books always feels warm and fuzzy, and it just makes me happy. So those are the five things that I love to read about in books. My Bookish Turn Offs video was probably a lot longer, but that's because it's much easier to rant about things that you hate than to exactly pin down why you love something. I don't know, weird things about life. But tell me what things you love to read about. What are your bookish buzzwords, bookish turn-ons, whatever you want to call them. Tell me in the comments. I love you, and I will see you later. Bye!